What's up guys, this is the Rifleman, and I am back bringing you to the next part of my Empire Total War Let's Play as Prussia. And I can't remember what happened last time. I think I pretty much kind of captured Genoa and Milan. I was heading down southwest, but southeast, but the most important news was that during the course of since recording this video and recording my last United Provinces videos, which was a couple of days ago, I have recently passed the 500 subscriber milestone, so thanks a lot for staying subscribed to me, and the new subscribers have joined. Welcome, I hope you enjoy what's happening. I do have something planned for you guys. Something is kind of a thank you for supporting me, and it will be another series I'm starting up, which hopefully you guys enjoy. But I won't say too much because it's going to be a surprise. Well, I'm going to enjoy doing it, and you guys are hopefully going to enjoy watching it, so. But just kind of ran off at least what I think I was doing. Well, I'm pretty sure. Well, I know what I was doing. This army was going to head down, capture Corsica, Rome, Naples, and Sardinia, and kind of secure the Med, and then land in Tunis. Then these armies over here, the garrison force in Vienna was going to expand. Or, no, as is, it was going to move out and start attacking this Russia-Polish stacks. They were going to. It was going to head eastwards, clear out these forces, while having a garrison force to prevent Austria from attacking me. And this guy, this force here, is going to sweep to the east to take out this Polish force. But it looks like I've run out of money and time. Let's have a good technology. Yeah. All my political research is going ahead as planned. I think my Prussia campaign's gone quite well. My economy's fine. I mean, I could be earning more, but it's fine. It's sustainable. Allied with the Ottomans. I'm at war with barely any major nations. Spain, Russia, and Poland. So that's fine. I'm trading with lots of people. So I'm feeling quite happy. I'm quite happy with the way this has gone. But I'm just going to hit end turn. But I should say again that I am pretty close to finishing this. I think I got to capture 4 more regions and Copenhagen. And then that's the... this campaign will be... hit space. Then this campaign will be completed. Spain is going to be raiding all my stuff. But yeah, 4 regions, and then I've captured... Well, then I've completed... this campaign is Prussia, so I hope leading up towards the end of it, you guys have enjoyed what I'm... No. I don't want alliance, I don't want a naval technology, and I don't need 950. But I hope you guys kind of at least have taken away the key lessons I've tried to get across through playing as Prussia, where it pretty much comes into, unless you play a diplomacy game well enough, which I'm sure you guys can totally do. I can't, because I'm a bit hopeless at that kind of thing. I just end up gunning for it and see what happens. Ooh. Better fix these economic buildings while I can. But it seems with Prussia, you've pretty much got to expect to be in a general situation of all-out war from the start. That's how I've always played it, and it does work, as you can see. But it's not ideal. I'm sure if you play the diplomacy game better, you could end up having a more effective campaign. And that, what was it? Technology. Workers on strike. How about now? Yeah, I thought so. Resistance to foreign occupation, that'll go down. Alright, let's start upgrading stuff. Yes, they can be replenished. Ooh. See, this town is poor, this town is wealthy, so I'll make more money out of doing upgrading the Iron Master's works. Oh, actually, get rid of that. Fix the Governor's Palace. Because Milan should be an interesting fight. Not Milan, the Italian state. Never really fight against them. Lots of artillery, lots of bog standard line. Economics building still going up. Ooh, got lots of stuff I can build over here, actually. Don't really need to build a whole lot. Well, at least can upgrade some, can build some nice units. Have I got the Army Staff College? I think I do. It looks like there's some cool units. Heavy cav. Lots of really cool looking cav units. Something the United States doesn't have. In this game, doesn't have cool cav units. No. No new infantry units. But I don't really need to upgrade. Ooh. Infrastructure upgrades. Try and find a strong performing region and upgrade their roads. If they need it, that is. Yeah. Okay. Oh, damn, I forgot. Okay, let's do that. Oh. Milan. No. Madrid is completely open. Ah, that force heading through Paris is going to attack Madrid. I see. See, cause there can be a gap between me recording these things. Oh, they're going. They better not go for Turin. Ooh, Polish attack. No, not a Polish attack. Oh, just raiding. Raiding all my stuff. But no matter, they should ultimately be destroyed fairly soon. So I'm going to continue heading eastwards. Should I be complimented that everyone's coming to my university to steal technology? Are they going to raid my stuff? They're raiding it with Russia. Oh, Russia, you suck. Still. Path blocked. Ooh, all the notifications. Okay. New town emerges, Bavaria. Are you happy? You are happy. Here, have a craft workshops. I'll fix that pleasure gardens. New port emerges. Here, have a trade port. Because, I mean, trade is... I'm not getting any money out of trade and I haven't since the start of the game. If I fix this, I wonder if Corlin will instantly raid it and knock it down. Port blockaded. Chapter schools in Paris are going up. Start upgrading some of the economics buildings closest to Paris. I want to bring these guys down here. Yeah, I may as well take them out. I'm trying to eradicate them on the map. So, I'll see you guys on the battle map for trying to clear out Nazario Guerrero. Guerrero. Yeah. From the map. To stop them from... Just trying to kill another Spanish stack, which is raiding all my stuff. So, I'll see you guys on the battle map. Okay. As much as they are... As much as they are more of a veteran raiding force, my guys are veterans too. So... Not particularly concerned about being outmatched. So let's... Come on. There we go. Stretch these guys out into a good line. Keep the artillery close, but they're not going to be involved a whole lot because there's so few of them. Get these guys as my reserves. Get my general close. Get my cavalry on the right. Nice and open. Oh. Right. Let's try to get my cavalry in position. The rest of this stuff I'm not really fussed about. I'm trying to get my line in. Crassier is going on to the... Oh no, I'm not going on to the left. They're just forming up. If I can bring my cavalry around... Pow. That'd be pretty neat. I do like these hussars. All the Prussian units, they're my favourite. Hussar guards, actually. So they're just hussars, but they're hussar guards. Have a look at the stats. Ooh. Got a charge. They'll probably get chewed up. Ah. Come on. There we go. Run the map again. Their cuirassiers are holding out. Two second horse guards. Yeah, I've got a light horse. Ideally, I want them to deploy against my infantry, which they're going to. Oh, actually, they're going after my cavalry. Got to make them charge to keep hold of that charge bonus. Although, this might be the end for my cavalry. Because we saw what happened last time when cuirassiers and light horse. Oh, they're doing quite well. My guys are losing quite a lot of men, though. They're losing more of them. Cavalry charges, not really fussed. They're dragoons. Dragoons, they'll be killed easily. Ooh, they're still down for losing. Yeah, I should be fine. I'd like to annihilate these infantry units. Not fussed about the dragoons. If I can win this cavalry fight. Excellent. I want them to hold, however, because these cuirassiers have not deployed. See if I can tempt them. These dragoons are still alive. 52 men, they should be dead soon. I want to tempt their cuirassiers into charging, because my men, actually they dealt with that quite good, but they're winded now. Oh, they're winded as well. Still. Oh, they're still within range. God. Look, just kill the bodyguard. Actually, no, don't deploy my general. These guys will do it. Because that's one thing Darthmod did, is he tweaked it to make infantry more powerful on the charge, but they also made them... They made cavalry more powerful on the charge, but they also made... they're more vulnerable to drawn-out infantry fights. Besides which, I love upgrading my guys to have bayonets as soon as possible. Royal Spanish Guard. Oh, they're coming back. If they can waver, that would be ideal. There we go. Get some flanking manoeuvres on, because I want them to deploy their cuirassiers. It's not shifting them around on the flank. Stretch these guys out a bit more, so that should get the cuirassiers within range. Whether they'll choose to target them in advance or not, I don't know. This is their general's unit. Let's deploy my hussars, see if I can convince their cuirassiers. 75, 86. Get a 75 strong hussar unit to charge their Spanish guard. Come on. Scattered infantry formation. You love it. Come on, charge. Damn it. Got to charge their general, because otherwise he's just going to massacre my units. Then get stuck in there with my line, because my guys will lose on a 1v1. Ooh, special unit. Get my infantry stuck in. May as well get on a little bit of micro to kill these guys. Because he's a Royal Spanish Guard. And Spain does have some really cool looking units. So, although I'm not going the... What I have particularly thought of for my 500 subscriber kind of special... isn't a Spanish playthrough. Let's continue. Although that isn't the case, it's certainly going to be considered, because they have loads of really cool looking units. I'm just going to speed up, because there's nothing really left to do apart from clean up these guys. Three units of cav should be able to clear them out. Should. I'm making some pretty heavy claims. on what the AI should and shouldn't be able to do. Come on, how many of them are there? 7. Oh no, they might make it. No, they won't. They're still a good ways away yet. But where's the other units? 5. I've got to make one unit chase down these guys, otherwise they'll get away. Come on. There we go. Oh, they're going to make it as well, aren't they? No, they're not. Haha! Okay, guys, I will see you back on the campaign map. As you expect, they were soundly beaten, and hopefully that's the end of... Nope, damn it. Set them to replenish. Because I want these guys to be the ones to push. Actually, they'll probably take on these guys. Take on this garrison at Biscay. No, Bilbao. Take out them, and head down to Madrid. Genoa has Gibraltar. Oh, I've checked all these. Actually, he's gained a trait. Steady under fire. +1 morale in battles. Oh, doesn't matter. He's blocked. Ooh. Do I have an attack coming? Interesting. Well, this force is going to head in this direction and threaten... their southern flank. Because right now, I think their only option here is to, yeah, is to attack Warsaw, which I have walls, and strong line, so that'll be fine. Upgrade some. Ooh. Start looking at no. Want to look at economic buildings I can upgrade. Chapter school, meh. Ah. Repairs are just as good. Because these can all be upgraded. Nah, dry dock, not really fussed. Port. Oh, I'm getting some trade off here. Oh, no, I'm not. Is Prussia being blockaded? Persia. It could well be. Russian fleet. They'll probably raid me. These guys are still replenishing. Ooh. They have a little stack there, but that's a couple of line units and some artillery. If I can engage them in one fight here. No, I'll probably have to head eastwards, take out these guys. But if I do that, that'll open up this direction. Ooh, better actually try fix these. Well, can't afford it. But if I head this stack over here to deal with them, it opens up the potential for one of their stacks to head up the western side of Italy and capture Genoa, just kind of in a stabby back moment. I don't know. I could get this fleet, this army to do it. Wander over the border, kill these guys, head back. Yeah, let's do that. Hopefully I can all resolve it, because I don't really... Yeah, you guys don't want to see that. They're also heavily depleted. Right. Get them back to garrisoning Venice. The reason I have this army sat here doing pretty much nothing is just to prevent an Austrian stack heading westwards and capturing it. Because the AI can be really, really backstabby sometimes. I'm going to keep them in my territory because I think I get a bonus in terms of replenishment. But they will be heading southwest. Which would be neat. Ooh. Nothing... It'd be cool if I can have one. Well, if they move, I'll just make them attack me. I don't think I can recruit any. No. Well, I don't have any money, and B, I can't recruit any. Oh, grenadiers. No, I couldn't recruit them anyway, because you can see at the bomb when it pops up. The amount of these items you can own is limited. You can currently have 6 of 6. Which is fine. I like that kind of mechanic, because it means you can't just suddenly spam loads of prime units. Right. Check all my tech is going, platoon firing. Do I really need to worry about... Well, ideally I want engineer school, really. Because right now I've got all my... No, I want Jaegers though, don't I? I do want Prussian Jaegers, but the campaign might end before I get to them. Well, let's hit end turn anyway, because nothing more is going to happen, because everyone's replenishing. Might have a defensive... Ooh. Flupple. They want to buy... Yeah, let's do it. They only have one region anyway. Normally I don't like selling technology. I like to make them earn it, but they've got one region. They've probably got one farm. Ooh. Oh no, they've bypassed me. And they're laying siege. Ugh. Okay, well, the garrison force at Königsberg is going to head and kill that stack. I swear this is the exact same offer as last time, except maybe it went up by 10. No. Right, so they're raiding behind my lines. Oh, and they're already moving to defend that. Right. Got garrison force. Well, this army is going to move out. Garrison force in. I would get a nice garrison anyway. But there you go. 5 more line plus garrison forces. That's fine. Now this stack, you are going to take out the Russians. Because remember, they got a Russian stack moving up this road. God damn, it's all on fire. See, I could move up and try like hitting them in the rear. But I'd like to have a siege fight, because they're always a bit more interesting. But I think this guy might pull back here. And try to clear them out. This army... Oh, they can take them out. They're so close. I'm probably not going to fight it because it's all cavalry, so... Boop. Victory! Yeah, let's see if I can get away with it. Oh no, I might not be able to get away with it. Oh no, in one turn they won't make it to Poland. They won't make it there instead, either, rather. Good. Let's fix... Okay. Blockaded, blockaded, raid. Research, blockaded. City besieged. Rebellion? That's unfortunate for them. Ooh! I see you. Well, first, let's try kill them. Then kind of hang around here. Because I think... That should mean if they try and move around me, my action zone still encompasses the bridge, so if they try and move, I should be able to, say, invite them to attack me. Unless, how happy am I with Austria? Very friendly. I can't request an alliance because they are allied with the Iroquois and the Cherokee. Okay. Request peace. Why? Here, have a power loom. Peace treaty? Okay, then that should be fine. Austria, there you go. Request... Oh, no, wait, I am an ally. How do I... Can I ask them to become... No, I can't. But we are allies, which means this army can deploy to move to do stuff. So now I have two armies, which I should have done a while ago, actually. But no, you guys probably want to fight. So, reasonably so, let's get this guy over here. Okay, guys, I will see you on the battle map to fight Nikolai Nikolin. Okay, I'll see you guys on the battle map. I think I might be right in thinking this is one of the first fights against the Russians. I think. Let's make standard line with artillery flanks. And then give each flank a line unit. Well, this flank will have a militia unit instead of a line unit. Get Lightfoot ready to deploy ahead. And... oh, this side will just have a line unit. And a light infantry unit. Get them in a light infantry formation. Group them up, keep cavalry on the right because it's more open. It seems like if I could get a charge, they would charge down into them. And the general's bodyguard. Oh, wow. Okay. Oh, look at that. First shot. First shot. I'm never that lucky. Right. Actually, you guys can limber up. Got a feeling I want to head in this direction. I want to flank their artillery position. Oh, I think some of them have bugged out. Oh, there we go. Okay. Let's move up. Get these guys firing at their artillery positions. Ooh, looks like that should have not... ooh. See, ugh, okay. Let's get a flank on round here and run. Keep my cavalry to guard my artillery. Although I might get some friendly fire right here. Actually, make him target the line infantry behind them. Who are they? Militia. Whatever, they're melee militia. A sneaking suspicion artillery is not going to get much of a look in this fight, so I'll bring these guys up to join the other battery, but by the time they've reached there, it's probably not even going to be still going on. Group and run. Get these guys on the extreme flank. Get this light infantry unit to plug the gap and run. Try to get a bit of a pincer movement going on. Pull this line back a bit because they're starting to move up with line. I think Russian line is inferior. It's an inferior line infantry unit, which is why they get 330 something, and I get 225. But there you go. We're firing on them. They're not returning fire. Hmm. Well, that gives my lines a good chance to form up. I could charge over the hill, they're militia after all. They've got these weird kind of axe things, but they're just militia. Oh, there we go. These guys might run into my line of fire? No. Wait for them to get a good distance away. Nah, that's good enough. And charge my line up. Oh, as long as he's got to get in position for the second light. Oh, they're charging. Smart decision by the AI. They're charging the line formation, the lines which aren't actually set up properly yet. But they will still die because they're Hussar units. These guys won't get a shot off. I could have made them form square, but it's not really necessary. They're such a weak infantry. They're such a weak cavalry unit. Lots of friendly fire by my light infantry. There we go. So the actual fight's begun. My light infantry units pouring fire into the Russian dogs. My guy's gonna be well and truly knackered from all of this. But knackered infantry can still fight. Not as good as rested line infantry. Completely agree. But it's fine. Get my artillery to fire on their militia. They might be coming after this. Oh no, they're forming a line. That's what they're doing. They're forming a line to combat this line. Not going to happen. Get these guys to relocate. Move out my line. My light, rather. I like light infantry. Okay. Artillery's missing its target, so may as well make them target this unit of line, because there's a geographical anomaly in the way. Bang. Like that. It would be even better if I could replace all my light infantry units with Jaegers. General's bodyguard is getting into position. Look at that. They're going to charge the rear, but again, doesn't really matter. May as well just make them charge. It says combatant winning. They're winning right now, but they won't soon. Yeah, wavering. So they're winning and wavering. Okay, now I'll make them form square because they're about to be charged by a second unit. Nudge these guys forward to maintain the cohesion. There you go. These guys might be about to get flanked. No matter. Okay, these guys are my core line. Shift them forward. Forward enough that the southernmost rank might actually be in danger of being shot at. Because the arc of fire might... Nah, that's way too big. Charge the militia at the same time deploy my cavalry. because while they're militia, they're lots of melee-specific militia. And like these guys. Let's get back over here. Cavalry charge should break them. I think that's the thing I've never actually... They're killing my guys quite well, actually. Oh, wow, they are, actually. They're doing massive amounts of damage. Not much morale, but they've done a really good job. Like, their morale as a stat is weak. But they've done really well in terms of, like, 110 guys left. Still, here's the main fight. Oh wow, the militia's back. But they're close enough, they're gonna get some shots. Which I might even charge over to help take care of them. Run these guys over to support the attack. Get my light infantry on the right to get ready to target their general unit. Wavering. Shut the door on these guys. Let's halt artillery fire now. They're about to be done anyway. There you go, General's unit has deployed. I'll just keep my cavalry working on theirs. Man, light infantry getting some kills on the routing militia. Still, I want to kill their line. Really? Whoop. Battle isn't over yet. Don't know why I'm speeding up. It says they're winning, but they're losing men faster. Ultimately. Oh, thank God. My cavalry's dodged this. Oh. Oh, then my light's gonna kill my own cavalry, I suspect. Still says winning, but all the rest of their units are routing. May as well deploy my light infantry to shoot. I'm pretty sure if I make them do light infantry doctrine, that means they can shoot 360 degrees effectively. Yeah. So as much as the arc is pointing in this direction, they are now, they just turn. They like swivel depending on what direction the target is they're shooting at. They're not dependent on the firing arc. It says combatant winning and they've lost. Actually, let's do this. Oh, I shouldn't have done that. I wanted to swarm them with men. I'm going to end the battle there. Not much point carrying it on. But it's a victory! And I will see you guys on the campaign map. Okay, here's the results and they've been routed. They've got 131 men left remaining. Oh, but they still route in a direction which makes them annoying. Still, more importantly, I need to replenish my men for the push to the southeast. That's what I need. And hopefully they attack, because then that'll be super easy to defend. Fix. But looking at the time, I think that is it for this part. So thank you for watching, guys, and thanks again for supporting me and helping me get to 500 subscribers. So next target is that 1,000. So thanks again, guys, and I will see you next time.